ஓம் அம்மா, நோ த பேசிக்ஸ் ஆஃப் சனாதன தர்மா. டுடேஸ் டாபிக், விஷ்ணு தத்துவம் அண்ட் ஸ்பிரிச்சுவல் சிக்னிஃபிகன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தசாவதார் பார்ட் ஏ, எபிசோட் 50 பை சந்திரசேகர் ஜெயந்தி. டியர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், த கிரியேட்டர் ஆஸ்பெக்ட் ஆஃப் காட் is called as Brahma. The sustainer aspect of God is Vishnu. The destroyer or assimilator aspect of God is Shiva. Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva, creator, sustainer and assimilator. Vishnu bhaktas consider Vishnu as the supreme God and worship him as the creator, the sustainer and assimilator of the creation. He is considered as the source of creation. Lord Vishnu is also called as Narayana, Hari, Padmanabha, Sheshasayana and many names. Narayana means, Nara means many, all these beings. Ayana means who controls them or who sustains them. And Hari means who takes away all our negativities. Regarding Padmanabha and Sheshasayana, we'll be discussing in the next slides, dear friends. In Mahabharata, Bhishma advises Yudhishthira about 1000 names of Vishnu, which is called as Vishnu Sahasranamam. The chanting of it is very sacred to millions of Hindus. Every day, Vishnu Sahasranamam is chanted in millions of houses. Adi Shankara wrote commentary on Vishnu Sahasranamam, dear friends. Now, let us analyze the first sloka of Vishnu Sahasranamam, which gives the definition of God also. Om Vishnum Visvam Vishnur Vashatkaro Bhuta Bhavya Bhavat Prabhu Bhuta Krit Bhuta Bhavo Bhutatma Bhuta Bhavanaha. This is what the first sloka of Vishnu Sahasranamam says, dear friends. The meaning of his Visvam means he is the universe. He pervades all the universe, all the cosmos. He is the Yajna. Vashatkaro means Yajna. Bhuta Bhavya Bhavat Prabhu means he is the Lord of past, present and future. Now, Bhuta Krit means he is the creator of all beings. Bhuta Vrit Bhavo means he nourishes all the beings, and he is the all. Bhava means he has become all beings. He is the Bhutatma means he is the soul of all beings, dear friends. Bhuta Bhavanaha. Bhuta Bhavanaha means he multiplies all the beings. So this is what it is the meaning of first sloka of Vishnu Sahasranamam, dear friends. Now he is adored as Shiva, Shambhu, Ishana, Rudra and Brahma in Vishnu Sahasranamam. Now, dear friends, there is one more sloka which we can analyze from Vishnu Sahasranamam. Visvamurtir Mahamurtir Deeptamurtir Amurtiman Anekamurtir Avyakta Shatamurtir Shatananaha. That is what it is said in Vishnu Sahasranamam. Means his form is the universe. He is having the greatest form. His form is splendid and radiant. He is also formless. Amurti. Amurtiman means he is also formless. He is having many forms. Anekamurti. He is unmanifested, avyakta, unmanifested. He gives lives to some satamurtir. He gives lives to many forms. And he is with satananaha, with many facets, many phases. So in Purusha Sukta, it is described as sahasrasirsha purushaha, 1000 heads, 1000 hands, 1000 legs. That is the all-pervading nature of Vishnu. So Vishnu means who is all-pervading consciousness, who is the source of the creation. So this is what the Vishnu Sahasranamam talks about Vishnu. He is both Murti and Amurti. He is with forms and without forms also, dear friends. Now, let us discuss the meaning of Anantashayana or Sheshasayana. Lord Vishnu is depicted as laying on the huge snake on the cosmic waters. The word Ananta means infinite. We have already discussed that Vishnu means the who pervades everything. We have already discussed that. Now, Sayana means sleep. It is a yogic sleep, means pervading everything. Yoga Nidra represents unmanifested universe. From his navel, the creating aspect of Brahma is depicted. That's why he is called as Padmanabha. Padmana, he is having the Padma. From the Padma, the whole Kalpa, the whole creation has come, which means the Brahma has come from him, which means the manifested universe has come from him. So manifested universe is small compared to unmanifested avyakta universe. This is how our Purusha Suktam also says the same thing. So manifested universe is small compared to unmanifested universe. The snake represents the poison of the world and water represents the samsara. He is laying on the snake means he is not affected by the ill effects of samsara. So he is not attached to any worldly things. He is beyond the dualities of the world. So nothing affects him. So for him, it is a play. It is a leela. It is like the samsara is just like a leela. So that's what the Anantashayana depicts, dear friends. Now, the goddess of wealth serves him. Means the prosperity is under his control. It is his shakti. It is his energy. The prosperity, the wealth is his. When you create, the prosperity of the creation is his shakti. That is wealth. So wealth is bestowed by him. The prosperity is bestowed by him, dear friends. Now, Vishwarupam and Lord Vishnu's ever splendid form. Lord Krishna, the Purnavatar of Vishnu, shows the cosmic form to Arjuna by giving him the eyes of knowledge. Arjuna could see the whole cosmos in Vishnu, the form pervading everywhere and embedded with everything in the universe. The form is complete. The form is all pervading. And it has everything in the universe. That's what Arjuna sees when Krishna shows him the Vishwarupa. Now, Arjuna, being filled with fear by seeing the cosmic form of Vishnu, seeks to see the ever-splendid form of Lord Vishnu with four arms, with Shankhu, the conch, the chakra, the disc, and the gada, the club. Then the Lord Vishnu appears to him in that form. That is Shantakaram, Bhujagasainam, Padmanabham, Suresham, Vishwakaram, Gaguna Sadusham, Megavarnam, Shubangam, Lakshmikantam, Kamalanayanam, Yogi Hridhyana Gamyam, Vande Vishnum, Bhavabayaharam, Sarvalokaikanadam. This is what the Chaturbhuja form of Sri Mahavishnu is described in this sloka, dear friends. Let us discuss about the Vaikuntham, the abode of Lord Vishnu. Bhagavatam says that Vaikuntham is the abode of Vishnu, which is above all the celestial worlds, where there is no sorrow and only liberated souls who are beyond desires dwell there serving Vishnu. This is what Bhagavatam says. Then how can all pervading Vishnu has a particular abode in the entire cosmos or entire space? That can be explained from Bhagavad Gita. It says, Ahamatma Gudakesho Sarvabhutas Sayestita Aham Aditya Madhyam Cha Bhutanam Antameva Cha. This is what Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, 10th chapter, 20th sloka. He says, I am the Atma, the soul of all beings, O Arjuna, seated in the hearts of all living entities. I am the beginning, the middle, and the end of all beings. Here he is saying that I am dwelling in the heart of all beings. That's what Lord Krishna is saying. Again, he repeats the same thing in Bhagavad Gita. He says in 15th chapter, Sarvasya Chaham Hridi Sannivishto, means I stay in the heart of all beings. What does that mean? Again, in 18th chapter, he says, Ishvara Sarvabhutanam Hrudayeshu Arjuna Tishti Brahmayan Sarvabhutani Yatra Rudani Mayaya. That is what Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita in 18th chapter. So Lord is repeatedly saying that I dwell in the hearts of the people, all beings I dwell in. So he means that. So what does that mean? The abode of Vishnu is Vaikuntham, but that Vaikuntham can be our hearts, and it can be also be the all pervading the whole cosmos, not just in our own hearts, but in the whole cosmic beings' hearts. So dear friends, that's what Adi Shankara also, while giving the commentary, he says we have to meditate on the Lord who is in our heart, and we also have to meditate on the all beings that are on the external world. That's what Adi Shankara in his commentary on this sloka was explaining. Now, even in Bhagavad Gita again, Krishna says, Yumam paschati sarvatra, sarvanchamaya paschati. That's what he says. Where people who see me in all beings, and similarly, who sees all beings in me, all beings in me, they will not be invisible to me, and similarly, I'll be always visible to them. That is what Lord Krishna is telling in Bhagavad Gita. So, dear friends, when you see God everywhere, when you see Him as the abode of Vishnu everywhere, then every being becomes, heart of every being becomes Vaikuntha. Similarly, our own heart becomes the Vaikuntha, dear friends. Only when we are eternally awake to the Vishnu consciousness can only perceive this. That's what the Gudakesha means, who are awakened from the sleep. Gudakesha means who is awakened from the sleep. The sleep means Maya. The sleep means yoga. Sleep means the deep slumber, the ignorance. So who have overcome the ignorance, who have the yogic eyes, could only see, or who are the eyes of devotion, or who are having the eyes of jnana, can only see the Vaikuntha in every being and within his one own heart. Avataras of Vishnu, dear friends. Although I am never born, the Lord of all living entities and eternal, the imperishable one, yet I manifest in this world by the virtue of my own yoga maya. He says, Sambhavami Atma Maya, he says that word. And by the keeping the control of Prakriti, this is what he says in 4th chapter, the 6th sloka in Gita, dear friends. Now here, whenever harm happens to Dharma, and whenever there is increase in Adharma, I manifest on this earth, he says in next sloka. Then again, to protect the righteous, to eliminate the wicked, and to re-establish the Dharma, I manifest again and again, he says, dear friends. So, paritranaya sadhunam, vinashayasha duskrutam, dharma samsthapanardaya, sambhavami yuge yuge. That's what he says. To protect the righteous, to eliminate the wicked, and to re-establish the dharma, I manifest again and again. That's what sambhavami yuge yuge means, again and again. There is a meaning like again and again is there in Sanskrit, dear friends. So, dear friends, so avatar means manifestation of the divine Vishnu in various forms, coming on to the earth, taking the birth like a human being, and not only human being, and any being, and doing to set right the dharma. So we'll be dealing with avatars in next episode, dear friends. But here in Bhagavatam, it is said there are 24 avatars of Vishnu are mentioned. In many Puranas and Mahabharata, some 10 avatars of Vishnu are mentioned. But the avatars vary from Purana to Purana. So normally it is said, Masya Kurma Varahasya Narasimhasya Vamanaha Ramo Ramascha Krishnascha Baudha Kalkirevacha. This is what generally taken. But few people take say it, Ramo Ramascha Ramascha. They consider Krishna as the Purna avatar, and they say that Rama Rama Parashurama, Sri Rama and Balarama as the avatars of Lord Vishnu, and they considered they equal Krishna, directly equal Krishna to Vishnu because he is a Purna avatar. And some consider Buddha in 10 avatars, and some don't consider Buddha in 10 avatars. So all these things we'll be discussing, and we will also be discussing the spiritual significance of the Dashavatar in next episode. Om Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.